game here before deciding who the two players are that are going to advance indeed are. And Sean, I have to admit, I've been a little bit greedy lately since I've been introducing all the players. So please, it is all you.
How dare you, you beautiful, saucy man crush of mine? In the bottom left corner, from America, it is Dignitas' Select.
And up in the top left side, gonna be Vortex, man. He's shown us he can almost hold off a rush in game number one. In game number two, he completely crushed it, as Select was unable to establish any of those forward bunkers at all. But he also didn't pull SCV. Select actually decided to go for the command center. And Sean, I'm curious on your thoughts. In game number one, he pulled the SCVs and it kind of worked. In game number two, he threw down the command center quickly with a quick follow-up. Do you have any opinion on which one you think is going to end up winning more games?
I mean, you have to be really, really good at reading what your opponent is doing. Very often you'll get players who will do things like build just four Zerglings and two Queens, intending to defend with drones and queens and go into the macro gang. If you identify your opponent underbuilding Lings, you can just box all the SCVs and go, go, go! And you can take them down with a pretty easy all-in. But of course, Select saw that there were a lot of Zerglings there, and when that is the circumstance, it's very reasonable to, of course, not bring any SCVs, to expand. Your opponent has deliberately dented their own economy by not building the drones. So
wait, Sean, don't look at the screen. Do you have any predictions on what Select's build is?
I would say that Select is probably going to cancel both these proxy bears because they just got spotted by a drone, and there's Vortex going, wait a minute, no, certainly not. Now, a lot of people are saying that Select is being a cheesy player, and all these games did so in the last TSL number 4 qualifier, but in fact, this is becoming his standard play of all people to do aggressive openings. I think Select would be the most well-suited to do it time and time again.
And also, it kind of reminds me of Tall Dream Altar in ZVP, where you see some players in tournaments, they always 6-pool on that map, but it is because it's a build that can definitely work out, and Select definitely feels comfortable either playing in the early game or is just not comfortable playing in the late game. But for now, this build is going to be pretty darn good. The SCV, is he going to be able to establish a bunker here?
He'll almost certainly do a low ground bunker just at the bottom lip of that ramp. You can actually wall some Marines in there if you start building structures properly. This is a very effective way to both defend the bunker and get some nice guaranteed damage. He's sending the SCV up. Again, he wants to see how many drones are coming. Are there Lings en route? There's the wall in. This is a very, very nice position to be in. Even if some Zerglings can slip their way up, you still have a nice, well-placed Marine. That building, the bunker on the top, is literally a high hit point vision up to the high ground.
Yeah, and the SCV is going to try to get out of there. He was protected by the Marine, still taking a lot of hits, though. Only at 5 HP. That's going to be very easy to snipe here, but we do have a Spine Crawler being constructed at the expansion for Vortex. He also has Zerglings on the way. They're spawning right now. Not going to be able to do that much damage. The Marine is loving his cheesy little spot he's found, but the bunker may get taken out, and he doesn't cancel it.
Wow!
That really sucks for Select here, as he needs every resource he can. You can see, barely able to afford everything he has going on here, but this rush is definitely not over quite yet. The Queen focusing out the SCV. It does go down. There are no more SCVs here to begin constructing those bunkers. He has to win with just pure Marine Micro alone. I don't know if he's going to be able to do it here, but the pressure is continuing. No more SCVs being brought off. No, three SCVs now are going to be joining the fray.
God, it's so unclear what the correct position is. I mean, look, right now Vortex is doing an amazing job slowly deflecting this push, and now with that Spine Crawler up, will he get the cancel off? He does manage to get that cancel, but he's slowly inching forward with these spines. It looks like Select is not done yet. He's going to try to target fire as best he can while that Spine Crawler is building. He might even try to do some sort of swing up into the main, though that would be very, very risky to do. And yes, he is. He has committed these Marines. He is on a drone hunting mission.
He's also going to try and kill the Spine Crawler from the high ground. He may be able to get it here, but the main problem is that the other Spine Crawler is still killing off those reinforcements. That did not get canceled. So both players now have made some minor mistakes as far as canceling is concerned. He is in the main base. The drones are completely undefended. The Zerg is going to get in on the fray, though. The Queen going to be joining from the ramp. The Marines are quickly dropping, but are they able to do enough damage here? It looks like three Hero Marines still trying to hang on. Unfortunately, I don't think they're Rambo Marines. They are eventually going to get cleaned out. The bunker on the low ground going to get taken out as well, at least with four Lings. Got to be able to do quite a bit of damage, but he hasn't really killed off that many drones here, Sean.
I mean, you see so many Zerglings out right now for Vortex. Select needs to back up and start going for the command center. He's still building Marines, still wants to try to pick off as many Lings as he so can, but the instant those Marines pop out, the Zerglings, nom 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 nom, they're gonna just clean up all them Mariners, and now Select is gonna have to go back into his long-term gameplay, force he'll kite as best he can. There's a small chance that he'll be able to knock those Ling numbers down to an unthreatening amount, but for the most part, I think that we're gonna end up in a very similar position to last game. Hop into the unit station real fast, and we'll see that there's 22 drones for Vortex, and he is making another 12 Zerglings.
Yeah, I want to see exactly what he's going to do with these, but this time, one slight difference is that the Marines will be able to make it back inside this supply depot wall, so the Zerglings, even if they get a crazy surround on this barracks, they can easily lift off. He will have enough Marines to defend it. Both players are hovering quite a few resources here. We'll see exactly what they plan to do with them. Select deciding once again to go for double command center here, and also the double barracks going to be going down, and Vortex, has he decided to expand?
Not quite yet. Vortex looks like he is deciding to go for some sort of Ling Baneling all in. I mean, he does have the one gas up. He's making more Zerglings. He's making another Spine Crawler. Now, this is... I would expect a Ling Baneling play once that many Zerglings have been produced, but the third Spine Crawler would indicate that Vortex thinks he's actually way far behind when, in fact, he's ahead in the supply count. Select will no doubt be going for some tech labs, be doing some marine marauder pushing. He's going to be walling off his front as well, but I think Vortex almost has to go for Baneling in this spot.
And indeed, he decides to go for that. Baneling nest just now getting started. The Ling count is up to 31. 24 drones to follow it up. He is making drones here and there, but also sprinkling in quite a few of those Lings, and we are going to see Select try and wall in here, so he will be relatively safe from this, but the problem is that this is a lot of surface area to cover. It's going to take either another barracks landing here or another bunker getting established right there, but we have seen in the past where Baneling Bus can still kill off these quite robust wall-ins that Terran players sometimes establish here, and with this many Lings on the field, Zergling speed nearly done. If nothing else, he'll be able to deny that third base for quite some time, but I don't think that's going to be his plan, as that Baneling Nest is now done. 24 more Lings on the way. Zergling speed moments away from being done. He doesn't have that much minerals or gas to spend on Banelings, but he will here in just a moment.
Oh, this is going to be very difficult for Select to defend. He does have only a bunker at the front. His Marines don't have speed yet. It looks like he'll even be pulling some up to the high ground to be able to defend. One Marine does step out into the middle, and when he sees that many Zerglings, immediately Select knows that something dangerous is up. All the Zerglings start to deal the damage. There's the repair. He might be able to keep it alive a little bit longer, but no, it looks like there goes all the frontal defense. All those SCVs will fall immediately, and Select now having to pull back up to the high ground, trying to go the bunker down on low. His combat shield might actually finish.
Yeah, Marines, very good versus just pure Speedling. Is Vortex going to go for continued Baneling pressure? Is he going to go for an expansion? It looks like he's still kind of doing a hybrid here, Sean. He's making drones and Lings at the same time. Moving on up to Lair Tech. And from what you've seen so far, do you expect Vortex to expand, or do you expect him to be continually aggressive here?
I would imagine that Vortex is probably going to do just one more round of aggression. He has his opponent's command center lifted. Even making a couple more units and delaying it another minute is more than justifiable. He hasn't committed to any drones yet. Excuse me, to any Banelings yet. He's still just making primarily drones. But at this point in time, I think Vortex is starting to feel like, yeah, I really got this. All I have to do is make sure that he doesn't take his expansion too easily, that he has to really fight for it.
82 supply right now to 50, and you gotta remember that is no roach supply. That is straight up Lings and drones. Two units that are good for the entire duration of a TBZ. It doesn't matter how long this game goes on, those Lings will still be useful. The main problem, though, is that he used up a lot of larvae doing that, so he has to get that third base. He does indeed, and he's going to be in a spot where hey, it's three base versus two base. That means I'm going to be in an okay spot here. His supply lead is quite substantial, and he's continuing with the Zergling production. We do have Baneling speed on the way, and right now it's just looking like he's going to continue with mass Banelings. And do you think, Sean, maybe he'll attack once he has Baneling speed, or should he just play it, like, ridiculously safe?
I mean, right now, building drones is absolutely what he needs to do. He's building only Lings. He's getting the Baneling speed. Vortex has turned his advantageous position into an all-in. He's going to have to do some massive damage with this speed Ling Marine bust. Select does have Stim finishing before the Baneling speed, so now Select is going to be able to do a little bit of hurting himself, and right now this is the exact reason why this bust is so risky. The only anti-air that Vortex has is going to be the Queens. What else can Vortex do to defend? He's going to have to bring all those Zerglings back. If he were going for a Mutalisk, that would be fine to pull back with the Zerglings, but since he is going for this Baneling speed upgrade, oh, 32 Banelings in production at the front! He might have to cancel all those, Mike.
Does need to be very, very careful. Here comes the drop right now at the natural one in the main as well. Is he going to elevator them? He has such a good position here behind these minerals, and he's going to be happy to see there's only pure Zerglings right now, and indeed he has had to pull all of them back here behind the minerals at both locations. One of them does finally get loaded back up, but the drone massacre has begun, killing every single drone almost inside the main base, and the Marines are going to escape. Every single Marine except for one has gone down. Such good decision making here by Select, completely punishing this all-in style that Vortex has decided to go
a
with.
A drop in the main, a drop at the third expansion for Zerg, doing some huge hurt, and it looks like Vortex realizes that yet again, his only play by going for these speed banelings is to go all-in. He's swinging up to the front. Select does not have the tank siege. Select is going to get overrun. Every one of his units packed tight together. The third base getting ready to fall for Zerg, but it looks like Select's name is where he's going to have the worry.
Needs to keep that tank alive. It does get surrounded. SCV is brought off the line. The Baneling count is now down to zero, and the SCV
is zero,
but it does look like one remaining Baneling. It does kill that off, and even though the positioning was great, right now all the SCVs got to get taken out. This drop up here is not going to be enough to actually end the game. These SCVs seemingly having unlimited HP with that medevac helping to heal them out, but it does finally run away there. Loads them up inside the medevac. The rest get left for dead here. This is looking pretty good for Vortex, Sean.
Up in the third base, it looks like we see Select does take down the third expansion. More Zerglings, more drones in production. Select not quite paying attention, loses all those Marines. Those are some of his only reinforcements. And amazingly, Mike, I think Select, one of the big favorites to even get into the Team Liquid Star League, might fall right here and now to the Spaniard Vortex.
He does manage to finish his wall in, though, taking the risk, lifting off those buildings. But his wall in is quite strong here. He's got the 1,300 HP Starfort, as well as the 1,000 HP Barracks there to complete that wall. And he is able to save this command center. He has three command centers in his main base. But, Sean, where do you mine when you have this many mules versus that many mineral patches? He's going to use every single last mineral in his main base to try and break out. But you gotta remember, Vortex has been sitting on quite a lot of drones here for a while compared to his opponent. 41 to only 4 SCVs. And you know what? Select may have had a better chance here, but there's just no patch lately. Here it comes right now. A huge bust. Is it enough? Yes, it is. The Marines are got the micro like crazy. The Mule's getting in on the action. But unfortunately, that is not gonna be enough here. And
there's the good game.
Vortex.